RaeAnna Goss, thank you so much for joining the Charlotte Mason Co-op. We are so excited to have you here teaching music. Please just tell us a little bit about yourself, your background, and about your class.
I am so excited as well. So my background is actually coming from a music teacher. I am a second generation homeschooler. So when I was growing up in the 80s and 90s, my mom homeschooled myself, my two brothers, and homeschooling gave me the opportunity to really pursue my passion, which was music. So for the whole 12 years of, or 13 years of homeschooling, I was taking private music lessons and strings and piano and band, and then was able to go to Lee University to study music education and graduated from Lee and began my career as a music educator. So it's been a really crazy life, just moving from that life as a teacher and educator to having babies myself and making the choice to leave the public education institution where I had a wonderful experience because I loved teaching music, but I knew that raising my children in my home, with the principles that we felt could be taught to our children through home education was the best choice. So it's just been really, really fun being able to bring that experience as a music educator in the schools into a homeschool environment with co-ops and groups locally and now online. So I'm really, really excited that we can bring this to online to people all over.
Yeah, it's going to be fabulous. And I love that you're not only a music expert, but you're a Charlotte Mason music expert.
Yeah, so I'm also a second generation Charlotte Mason as well. My mom bought the pink volumes from a Mary Pride conference. And she did not have the support that we have now. There were no forums. There was no online back then. So like, I always really praise my mom that she was able to homeschool us without the internet. So
What a trailblazer.
Yeah. So she knew of Karen Andriola and read the first volume and made sure that we had a lot of nature experiences. We would go on nature walks every day, rich literature in our homeschool. So
fabulous.
So it's really exciting that I can carry on this tradition with my children as well and give them a feast that my mom gave me.
Yes. So beautiful. Okay. So tell us about your class, Fun with Solfa and Composer Study.
Yes. I am certified in Orff Schulwerk, which is a music education pedagogy philosophy.
Okay.
And it uses solfa, just like the Kadai methodology as well. Right. So I am familiar with what I would call sequential learning, similar to what Charlotte Mason and the schools in England use. They use tonic solfa, which was before Kadai. Now, today, if you go into any music school, you will most likely encounter solfege being taught from a Kadai methodology or Orff Schulwerk. So I approach solfa with the same principles that were taught with the tonic solfa method by the Kerwins. However, updated research, and I know Amy has talked about that with updated brain research. You know, we can approach education now knowing more than they even knew back then. And, but we're still able to keep the same principles. That's what I love about Charlotte Mason, that it's all about the principles. So when I created Solfa Sofa, I wanted to still use those same principles. However, follow a sequential pattern a little bit different than tonic solfa. For just a small example, the Kerwins in the tonic solfa book would start with do and then so, but I like to start with so me, because it's been proven that is more of a natural interval for children. So there's just little tiny things that are different between how I approach the sequence of learning solfa, but bringing in a lot of fun, a lot of games. And so that's the solfa part of my class. And then the composer part of my class comes from my love of music history. Music history is my favorite course in college. And when I was in the elementary schools, I had a composer every month. I wish I had known more about music study in Charlotte Mason schools while I was a public school music teacher. Instead of doing one composer every month, I would have followed the same principles of using one composer every term, so 12 weeks. So I developed Composer Study Companion following that idea of studying one composer for 12 weeks, listening to 6 examples throughout those 12 weeks. And that's what we'll do also in our online class. We'll be studying Verdi for the first semester.
I love it. Oh, it's going to be so wonderful. So tell us a little bit about what students and parents can expect. And you know, the whole family can join in too, right?
Yes.
So tell us a little bit about what they can expect during your classes.
So I would love to start with some warm-up things that is an activity that I would do in my classroom as well, of games like Poison Rhythm, where we'll talk about a certain rhythm, which is part of also learning solfa, is learning the intervals of singing and then also rhythm, a lot of music theory. So we'll do some little music games at the beginning. We'll go into some actual skill-based learning of solfa, and then we'll move into some time talking about the composer's life and listening to one of the examples. One thing that I think benefits this kind of class is that parents who might not have a musical background or knowledge in music history might default to just playing music and just playing the composer's song, but not really knowing what to listen for. So in our classes, what we'll be doing is before I play an example, or I might not even play a whole example of one of the songs by the composer, but I'll say, hey, you know, the composer used this really cool technique of question and answer during this section of the song. So when you hear the music go, da, 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 you know, that's going to be one part. And then here when it comes back, and maybe when it's repeated later on in the song. So things like that, where I can encourage the active listening of a piece and the understanding of why the composer wrote the song that way. Where classes will be about 30, 35 minutes long. And I also would like, because you said it's for the whole family, people may have different backgrounds and come from different skill levels. So I will need to approach the class in a way that involves everyone, but I would love to encourage growth individually. And so I hope parents will message me and say, you know, my child has had this many years of piano. They're already familiar with this. What do you suggest we could do at home to further that skill? So I feel like anyone, no matter what background they have, what experience level they have, we can meet together and grow and offer opportunities.
I love it. I think it's going to be great. And I love that, like, not only can anybody with any experience level, you know, join in, the whole family can join in, but that moms that sometimes feel intimidated, especially with some of the music components of a Charlotte Mason education, can do one of two things, right? You can outsource it to RaeAnna, or you can include yourself and learn from RaeAnna on how to do it yourself in your home. So I love that it's not only teaching the kids, but teaching the moms how to improve in these different subject areas for the co-op. It's a win-win all the way around.
I believe so. I'm excited.
All right, RaeAnna Goss, thank you so much. We're so excited. Go sign up for Fun with Solfa and Composer Study.
Yes. Yay. I look forward to seeing you.
Thanks.
Bye.